At over 20,000 kilometers above sea level is a constellation of satellites, each orbiting Earth every 11 hours and 58 minutes. These satellites are continuously beaming data down to us on Earth, which is in turn received by devices such as your phone or navigational units in your cars, allowing you to see where you are on the planet. There are a lot of misconceptions about how GPSs actually work, an example being that your phone and the GPS satellites are both talking to each other. So let's get down to it. How do GPSs work? GPS stands for Global Positioning System, which works through trilateration, not triangulation or multilateration, which is commonly misconceived. There are many different types of navigational satellite systems from countries across the world, but the most popular and commonly used system is Navstar, which is the USA system. There are, however, Russian, Indian, Chinese and European equivalent systems, although the Indian and Chinese systems sit in a geosynchronous orbit above their countries, which means they are not worldwide systems. The Navstar system, which is simply referred to as GPS, is what we will be focusing more on, although most phones and devices tend to have the capabilities to use both GPS and GLONASS. GPS satellites are set up in such a way that from almost anywhere on the surface of Earth, you should have a direct line of sight of at least 4 GPS satellites. This is quite important on the basis that GPS point positioning requires at least 4 satellites to calculate 3 position coordinates and the clock deviation. As GPS units are receivers, there needs to be something sending some sort of signal to devices such as your phone to receive. Each GPS satellite broadcasts a navigational message towards Earth, which contains an extremely accurate timestamp, which is obtained through an atomic clock which is on board these satellites. And the satellites also broadcast their position at the time of broadcast, with all GPS signals broadcasting at 1.5752 GHz and 1.2276 GHz. These two bits of information allow you to work out your position on Earth. With these satellites all sending exceptionally accurate time down to Earth, your phone or GPS receiver can compare the difference of time between when the signal was sent to when it was received to work out the distance between you and the satellite. By multiplying this time difference with the speed of light, as the signal is sent at the speed of light, you can begin to get the distance away you are from that satellite. As these satellites are also sending whereabouts they are, you can begin to draw spheres around the satellites, with you being somewhere on the outer border of that sphere. As we introduce more GPS satellites into the mix, we begin to get closer to where we are. By calculating the time differences between these satellites, we move from having no idea where we are to being able to pinpoint where we are, typically down to 5 to 10 meters on average, with the potential error being around 15 meters. There are a lot of factors which escalate the potential error, but the most significant is due to the ionosphere, a part of the upper atmosphere extending from 60 kilometers to 2,000 kilometers, where free electrons occur frequently enough to have an appreciable influence on the proportion of electromagnetic waves passing through this layer. This error is substantially smaller when satellites are directly overhead, compared to being larger the closer the satellites are to the horizon relative to you, as the path between you and the GPS satellites goes through more of the atmosphere compared to being directly overhead. Even things such as small variations in the atomic clocks found on board these satellites can cause major errors. A clock error of 1 nanosecond can translate to a 1 foot or 30 centimeter miscalculation. Then the theory of relativity kicks in, with the atomic clocks ticking ever so slightly slower than clocks which are stationary on the ground, which translates into a 7 microsecond a day delay. General relativity then also kicks in, with the effect of the gravitational frequency shift being far greater than the 7 microsecond per day delay due to the velocity relative to Earth. As the theory states that a clock which is closer to a massive object will be slower than a clock further away, the atomic clocks on board the GPSs are faster by about 45.9 microseconds per day. Combining the 7 microsecond a day delay due to the satellite's velocity relative to Earth and the GPSs being further away from Earth, this adds up to a 38 microsecond delay, which if left uncorrected would translate through to a 10 kilometer a day pseudo-range error, rendering GPSs invalid from the get-go if this was not to be taken into consideration. This is compensated by the GPS's clock's frequencies being slightly slowed down from 10.23 MHz to 10.22999999543 MHz to cancel out the effects of relativity. So next time you turn on your GPS on your phone or other device, you should now realize just how much physics and maths is going in towards you finding your own location. Thank you for watching, be sure to subscribe.